Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in Revit 2018 Imperial. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_007_DIAB_I where you save it. You can also download this file on the website. In today's tutorial, we're going to draw the foundation and footing. Now, go to the default 3D view on the quick access toolbar. If you look at the model, we only have the ground floor and the first floor plan. We need to grid the foundation plan. Now, if I go and double click the foundation plan, you see a wall on the foundation plan. When you go to the 3D view, you see that we have only walls on the ground floor and the first floor. Now, go to the elevation, maybe the front elevation to get this further. Now, you see the model only stops from the foundation, from the ground floor plan. Where this wall comes from in the foundation plan? The reason being that when you are working in Revit, Revit give you a view range. The cut plan of this view range determine what you see and what you are not seeing. Now go to the property palette, hold down the scroll bar to scroll down, and in the extension section, look for the view range and click the edit button. You see, the associated level above offset is 7'6". The cut plan is 4'. Let me cancel out of this dialog box and go to the front elevation. Zoom in closely. Let me click this and move it close to the model. The distance now go to the quick access toolbar and select the align dimension command. Dimension from the ground floor plan to the foundation plan. The distance between the two plans is 3 feet. Now if you have a cut plan of 4 feet, the cut plan go above the ground floor plan. So the walls that you see in the foundation are not the foundation wall. You see in the ground floor plan walls. Now I'm going to draw a reference plan by right-clicking this reference plan, grid similar. Then, in the draw panel, select the quick line method and enter an offset of 4 feet. I'm going to offset this from the ground floor plan, the foundation plan, to the top. You see, this is the cut plan. So since the cut plan is around where this wall are, that's why you see that wall. Now let's go and change the cut plan. Let's change it to 2 feet. That way the cut plan will be above 2 feet above the foundation plan and 1 foot below the ground floor plan. Go to the project browser and double click the foundation plan. Go to the view range by clicking the edit button and change the associated level offset to 3 feet and change the cut plan to 2 feet. Click apply and click OK. You see, now you notice that there is no wall in the foundation plan. This wall are gone. Let's do the same thing for the footing and change the view range. Change the associated level to 1 foot and the cut plan to 6 inches. Apply, close. Now go to the foundation plan. If I go to the architectural tab and select the wall command, then click anywhere to start drawing a wall, you see nothing. There is a lot of things responsible for this. Click the modify button and click the undo once to undo the wall. Now if I select the wall command in this view, then you see that this goes to the depth, constraint go to footing. Now if I change this to height, then change this to ground floor plan, then change the wall location to core face exterior. Now draw a wall. You see the wall is now displayed. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the property palette and under the underlay, click the down arrow and select ground floor plan to use the ground floor plan as underlay. Select the use a cousin window selection and click the filter button. Check none. Check the reference plan. Click apply and click OK. Go to the view panel. Click the down arrow and select height element. We want the wall of the foundation to be 2 inches thicker than the actual wall of the model. So click the wall command. Now select this. Try to select the underlay, but as for the moment, you can't select the underlay. If you have the same situation, go to the selection panel, click the down arrow, and place a check mark to the underlay element. Now you can select the underlay element. Right click on this element and select create similar. Make sure that you click the down arrow and change to height, and change the line location to core center line. Change the constraint to ground floor plan and zoom in into this area. Draw a wall from the center of this wall to this wall. Press escape once. Draw a wall from the center of this wall to this wall. Press escape once. Zoom out by rolling the mouse wheel backward and zoom in into this area. Hover the mouse cursor and move slowly to the center. Start from this face. Draw a wall from this point to this point. Press escape once to break the chain. Zoom in. Draw a wall from this point to this point. Press escape twice to get out of the corner. The reason why we draw this wall, we have this buttress run from the foundation to the first floor. We don't want them to have a different thickness of the actual wall of the model. So now go and select the wall command. Leave all the other settings as they are and go to the property palette. Click the down arrow and select the generic 8 inches. Select the generic 8 inches. Change the wall location to core face exterior and zoom in into this area. Start the wall command into this area. Move the mouse cursor up. If the wall go into the wrong direction, you can press the space bar to flip it into the right orientation. Now move the mouse cursor and click on this corner. Move the mouse cursor, click on this corner. Click this corner. This corner. This corner. This corner. This corner. Click the modify button to end the command. Click the wall command again. Make sure that this sets to height and this set to ground floor plan. Click to this corner to start a wall from this corner. Press the space bar if you are in the wrong orientation. Click to place the wall. Press escape once to break the chain. Click on this corner. Press the tab key if you are in the wrong orientation. Move the mouse cursor down. Zoom in into this area and click on this. Press escape to break the chain. Click on this corner. Press the tab key to the space bar to went in the right orientation. Click on this corner. Press escape one to break the chain. Click on this corner. Move the mouse cursor and zoom in and snap to this corner. Press escape to break the chain. Start on this corner. Move the mouse cursor and end the line to this corner. Press escape once to break the chain. Go to the option bar, click the down arrow and change to core center line. Select the pick line button on the draw panel. Zoom in into this area and pick the center of this wall. Zoom in into this area. Click on this grid, grid 3. In the draw panel, click the line button. Zoom in into this area. Draw a line from this grid and click to this corner. Press escape twice to get out of the command. Go to the modify panel and select the trim extend to trim extend single element. Select this face and click this foundation wall. Select this face, click the foundation wall. Go to the modify panel and select the align command. Click this face and click the face of this foundation to align it. Now click the modify button to end the command. Select this wall and delete it. Go to the default 3D view to see the results. Now the foundation is being added nicely. Click the X button to close. Now if I were add a wall with a different thickness to the top wall, you will have see the difference here. That's why I use the same thickness. Click the file tab. I've got the mouse cursor to save as projects. Rename this file 00_008_DIAB_I. Click the save button. Go to this bar and click the zoom to fit button to see the entire model. Alright, we're going to end the tutorial here. In the next tutorial, we're going to create the footing for the model. If you find this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your friend. If you have any question, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue this tutorial or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.